So which is why when opposition now comes, opposition you cannot fight, opposition that is bigger than you, God will arise. Not the people you have served, not the people you have helped. God will arise and make things happen for you. Amen. See, but the problem is a lot of us people, we do good to people that we expect them to do us good back. Somebody told me, after all the nice things you did to these people, they did this to you, and they are still demanding for you to do this, and we do it. I said, because I am not expecting them to do good back to me. I'm expecting God to do good for me. I don't want to be at the mercy of any human being. Amen. I'm at the mercy of the Most High God. Amen. Am I arrogant? No, you know I ask you for help if I need help. So I'm not teaching you arrogance here, I'm teaching you focus. When you focus your attention on God, that God is my resource, God is my help, God can then use anybody that He pleases to help you. But when you focus that, because in time past when things were rosy, I did this for this person. Now that I have this particular name, it's time for them to pay me back. That should never be your focus. Your focus is whatever you have done for anybody, let it go. Whatever you have done for the ministry, let it go. Whatever you have done for whatever sacrifice you have made, let it go. A lot of you, you even take that hold over your children. How I suffered for you. So, now it's your turn to take care of me. I have done it, you will do it. That you are a member of Shepherd's Place, that is not your portion. Yes. Resources will remain in your hand until you go to meet the Lord or the Lord comes to take you home. Yes. You are not going to, you see, some people, they have some stupid adage that when something, when, I don't know how they, but the implication is that when you grow old, then you begin to suck from your children. It's not your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever your children will give you will just be for pleasure. It will just be that they appreciate you. It will just be that you are just like, just humoring them, not because you need it. Amen. You are not going to grow old and be needy. Amen. That is not your portion. Amen. Caleb was 85, and his strength was not abated. Moses was 120 years old, and he was still strong and growing. That is your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Joshua again said, Joshua was 80. They said, we are still able. That the way we were strong 40 years ago, we are still that strong. Somebody, you are hearing this today. That is your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. 40 years from now, you will still be going. In the mighty name of Jesus. In strength, you will still be growing. In fact, your finances will even be skyrocketing. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. When you retire, your money will still be making money for you. Your investment will still be making more investment for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. There's no cutting short your glory. There's no cutting short your resources. Because you're a child of the Most High God. And you are holding on to that promise. You are holding on to His word. It will happen for you in Jesus' name. Amen. So you see, as Christians, the enemy will try to deceive us and say, you know, the Bible says children should take care of their parents. And children should actually do that. But it's just that parent, as a parent, for you, my covenant over you is, you will not be down and dependent. It's not your portion. Amen. You will have all that you need. Remember our declaration. Having all that you need for every good work. At 90, any good work you want to do, you have all that you need. If you live to 100, every good work that you need to do, you will have all the resources you need for it. In the mighty name of Jesus. But remember, that is whatever. So, what brought me to this point is, don't sit on your children. How I suffered for you. Now it's your turn. How I read for you. How I helped you to study. Now you don't want to love me. You don't want to respect me. Why are you begging for love? And why are you putting burden over the poor children? Please don't do that again. Do what you need to do for them and let them go. Come on, somebody. Let them go. Then you hold on to them. Then the children will try to wriggle out of your hands. Then they'll be playing all sorts of tricks on you. Why? The dignity is let the children go, they will come back, they will want you. Yeah. The dignity is I release you into the hands of the Most High God. Yeah. you reap, because you have done your homework too. You have prayed for them. You have taught them the way of the Lord. Now that they are grown, they will not depart from that way.
Amen.
But when you keep looking with torchlight, you will be seeing faults. If somebody looks into your life now, how do you think it will be? Allow the Holy Spirit to do His work on them.
Amen.
They say, if you don't send me this, you know what will happen to you. They shouldn't send you. Nothing will happen to them. And nothing will happen to you. You will not lack.
Amen.
So don't be afraid. And some of you think if you let them go, then you will be lonely. You will not be lonely. It's not true. And I see that evil in the generation past. And I don't want it to continue. You will see that somebody, parents will have like maybe 4, 3, 10, whatever, how many children. They will let all of them go, then they will pick one. And that one will never amount to anything.